What's wrong, Squeaks?
Oh, is the rain making you sad? I know you were hoping to fly your kite today.
Well, don't worry, buddy. I'm sure it'll go away soon.
You know, Squeaks, there are a lot of places that are way, way rainier than the fort.
It's true.
Right now, all over the world, people are experiencing different weather. In some places, it's sunny and dry. In others, it's cold and windy. And in some places, it's even wetter than it is here at the fort. And there's a good reason why. We all experience different weather because the places we live have different land and water features that make them unique. We're up high in the mountains, which makes it colder where we are than it is in some other places. Yes, and snowier in the wintertime, too. Scientists measure the different weather patterns in all of these places to learn more about what makes them happen and how to predict future weather changes. And because of certain conditions, there are some places where it rains a lot. Ooh, great question, Squeaks! Scientists can measure how much rain a place gets by collecting some of the falling water. They can't catch it all at once, so they use an object called a rain gauge to gather the rain in a small area. Then they figure out how much water fell, usually by measuring how many millimeters high that water is in their gauge. Then researchers can look at how much rain those places see over long periods of time. And they can use that information to identify the rainiest places on Earth. Do you want to learn about a couple of them? Awesome, let's take a look. There's a place in Hawaii called Mount Wai'ale'ale, which has the record for the most rainfall over 60 years. The average amount of rain they got in that time was 9,500 millimeters per year. That's twice as tall as a giraffe. Yeah, and it has been even higher at times too. The rainiest year they've ever seen was 1982, when they got more than 17,300 millimeters of rain. So, if we ever go and visit Mount Wai'ale'ale, we'll need to bring our rain boots for sure. Great question, Squeaks. There are a few things about Mount Wai'ale'ale that help make it so rainy. For starters, it's on an island that's farther north than the rest of the Hawaiian Islands. And because of that, it tends to be the first one to get hit by moving storms. The mountain is also surrounded by valleys on three sides. And these valleys help push storm clouds right up to the mountain itself. Kind of like when you carve a path in your mashed potatoes and the gravy all flows down that path. I love mashed potatoes too, Squeaks. And I love that scientists can learn things about weather patterns by studying rainy places like Mount Wai'ale'ale. But it isn't the only super rainy place on Earth. The area with the most rain in one year is Cherrapunji, India, which got more than 25,400 millimeters of rainfall from the summer of 1860 to the summer of 1861. That's as high as an 8-story building. And that same town has the record for the most rainfall in 48 hours, too. In 1995, it got splashed with 2,493 millimeters of rain in 2 days. That's almost as high as the tallest person on Earth in just a couple of days. Yeah. Another nearby town called Masinram is really rainy too. Masinram holds the record for the highest average rainfall over 30 years, with 11,872 millimeters of rain per year. Both of these places are in an area that has a wet season and a dry season. In the wet season, they get massive storms called monsoons, and these storms bring in lots of rain. Right, so that means these places usually get most of their rain in one part of the year, instead of more consistently like the fort. The monsoon season happens for the same reason we have summer and winter here. As the Earth tilts, it changes how much sunlight hits the planet. When the sunlight is stronger on the ocean, it makes more water evaporate. That means that there are more clouds, and those clouds get pushed over to the land by air currents. Good question, Squeaks. The monsoons are especially strong in this part of Asia because of the Himalaya Mountains. These giant peaks block any of the dry air from reaching the places that are the rainiest. So the storm clouds don't get pushed away anywhere else. Oh, right. I'm sure the kids living in those really rainy places have lots of games that they can play, even when it's raining. And I have a craft in mind for us to do today. Let's make our own rain gauge so we can figure out how much rain we get for the rest of today. For this craft, you'll need a tall, clear container with straight sides. An empty spaghetti sauce jar works great. You'll also need a ruler, a permanent marker, and some clear tape. Put a piece of tape up the side of the jar. Then use your ruler to make lines on the tape for every 5 or 10 millimeters. Seal in your markings by putting another piece of tape over the top. Then set your rain gauge outside in a place with nothing else above it. And wait. Once the rain stops, you can check how many millimeters of rain your area got. Ooh, I'm excited too, Squeaks. Let's go set up our rain gauge outside and start measuring. Thanks for joining us here at the fort. You can come hang out with us anytime, rain or shine. Just hit the subscribe button and we'll see you next time on SciShow Kids.